In today's video, we'll look at how to remove busy backgrounds from photos like this using Affinity Photo. Whilst there are a few ways we could do this, I'm going to limit the work to using only brush-based tools. I'll start by using the selection brush to paint over the subject area I want to keep. This is a great tool for creating a rough selection around the man because it's fast and can detect some of the edges. As I paint, you can see the dotted animated line of the selection appear. It's also a good idea to only work on small sections of the image at a time. That way, if the selection goes wrong, you can use the undo command. You can then redo the selection rather than needing to start from the beginning. I should also mention that if the man was on a clean background, selecting it with the selection brush would be much easier. It's all the different tones and colours that make this a difficult selection. Don't worry that the selection isn't accurate though, because there's an easy way to fix this, which we'll be looking at later. When you've made the selection, magnify the image and reduce the brush size with the square bracket keys. Making the brush smaller and the image larger means you can work more precisely. Now work around the edge of the object looking for missed areas to fix. If you find any, paint over them to add them to the selection. You'll probably also find areas you want to remove from the selection. You can do this by changing the selection brush mode to subtract in the toolbar at the top of the screen. When you're working with a selection like this, the dotted line can make it difficult to spot areas you've missed. An easy way to check is by clicking the Quick Mask Mode button in the toolbar. By default, it shows a red transparent overlay, but you can change it in the dropdown to black or white, which sometimes makes problems easier to spot. Then click the Quick Mask icon a second time to turn it off. Having created a rough selection of the man in the image, we now need to refine the edges. The easy way to do this is using the Refine Selection tools accessed from the toolbar. Depending on how well you made the initial selection, you may find the default settings in this dialog fix any problems. When an image has a busy background like this, I like to start by reducing the border width down to something like 2-4%. This controls how wide an area around the edge of the selection is refined by the tool. A lower value can sometimes improve the accuracy of the edge detection, providing you started with a reasonable selection. Now we can work around the edges of the selection to refine them further using the adjustment brush. The brush has four modes which you can access by clicking the buttons in the dialog. We can also resize the brush, making it bigger or smaller using the square bracket keys on the computer keyboard. When I use it in the foreground mode, it marks the area as part of the foreground that I want to keep. Then if I use the background mode, it marks the area as part of the background which will be removed. Each time I make a change with one of these brushes, Affinity Photo reanalyzes and refines the edges. The matte brush is particularly useful for reanalyzing any areas of the selection that aren't very accurate. As you refine the selection, try to work on a section at a time and zoom in. Using a small brush with a high magnification can produce a more accurate selection. When the selection looks reasonable, I'll set the dialog to output the results to a new selection. I'll then save this selection as a spare channel using the Select menu. I'm doing this because it's taken me quite some time to reach this point. Saving it gives me a point to return to if something goes wrong in the next step. Next, I'll convert the selection into a mask by adding a new mask to the layer. As this is the only layer in the image, it removes the background and you see the transparent checkerboard pattern instead. It's now possible to apply a new background to this image if we wanted to. But instead, I want to show you something else we can do to improve the mask. If we look closely around the mask edge with the image magnified, you can see areas that might benefit from being a clearer edge. We can clean these up by painting them with the paintbrush tool using black or white. Here I'm using the brush at 100% opacity and with a hard edge of 100% for speed, but you can refine these settings as you need to. Notice that when I paint with black, it hides the area. And if I switch to white by pressing X on my keyboard, I can reveal more of the image. Now watch what happens if we change the brush to overlay rather than the normal mode. I can paint over the edge of the mask to make slightly transparent areas clearer. It's a great way to clean up an edge in a mask that's too soft. You can also go back to the Refine Selection dialog to do more work there if you prefer. Just right-click on the layer, then in the pop-up menu, select the Refine Mask option. Although we're working on a mask and not a selection, the dialog has the same controls as before. Now I realise I haven't explained the controls in detail, because that's covered in this video, which you should watch next. It demonstrates how to precisely refine a complex selection whilst explaining the different dialogue controls you can use. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already done so. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you soon in another video.